So first topic about vector calculus is sketching of vector field. So usually, ang ini-sketch natin is two-dimensional vector field. Kasi yung three-dimensional, usually, ang ginagamit na natin dyan is software because of the complexity of the graph. Since three-dimensional siya, mahirap i-plot sa simpleng papel lang at mano-mano mo pang gagawin. So since 2D siya, so we're pertaining about only two axes. So for this example, the vector field is negative yi plus xj. So first step is to assign points that represents the four quadrant or four sides ng rectangular coordinate system natin. So for this example, we use 1 0 0 1 negative 1 0 and 0 negative 1. And then those individual points, so, di ba x, y yan? Kaya assign natin yan doon sa given na vector field, which is negative yi plus xj. So, for example, the first point is 1, 0. So, ibig sabihin dyan, x is 1, y is 0. So, substitute mo yung 1 dito sa xj. And then, the 0, substitute mo rito sa negative yi. So, given that, ito yung value for this vector field. So, ang kalalabasan dyan is 1, substitute mo rito, ibig sabihin, 1j, ibig sabihin, 1 yung j component or the y component. And then, 0 yung y component, substitute mo rito sa x component. So, negative 0 is still 0. So, 0, 1 ang kalalabasang point for the vector. So, doing such, ito na siya. So, 1, 0 naging 0, 1. And then, 0, 1 is naging negative 1, 0. So, check natin. 0 yung x. Substitute mo dito. So, 0j. So, 0 yung j component, which is this. And then, 1, ang y component, substitute mo sa vector field, which is negative y. So, negative 1. Kaya, naging negative 1i. Therefore, the point is negative 1, 0 for the vector field. So, doing such, ito na yung 4. And then, plot mo na. So, ito yung magiging reference mo for plotting yung given point mo. So, for example, this is 1, 0. So, nasa first quadrant siya, which is this. 1, 0. And then, saan papunta yung 1, 0? 0, negative 1. So, hindi ibig sabihin na pagdudugtungin mo yung 1, 0, tsaka 0, 1. What you need to do is to get the direction or to know the direction. So, since 0, 1 is papunta sa positive y-axis, sabihin, pataas yung graph natin. Same as with the other three. So, doing such, pwede pa kayo mag-assign ng other points para lang makita if the behavior of the vector field is consistent. Pero usually, if mag-graph ka, so okay na yung mga dalawang set of points. I mean, pag sabi mong two sets, so dalawa sa first axis, dalawa sa second axis, etc. Or quadrant rather. So, for your next topics, the operation of vectors. So, operation of vectors, yung papasok yung addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and then the magnitude. So, pag sinabi natin addition and subtraction, so, ang gagawin lang natin dito is just to add or subtract the same component. So, kung I siya, sa I mo lang siya i-add or isusubtract. But, the operation between the component I, J, and K is always plus. So, for example, vector A plus vector V, as in victory. Sige natin victory. Let's say, ang component ng A is AI plus AJ plus AC, and then your V component is V1 plus V2 plus V3, and then isusubtract mo yon. So, magiging ano dyan is, let's say, A minus VI. So, AI minus VI plus AJ minus VJ. Diba? And so on and so forth. So, yun ang operation of vector. So, here, for example, is P plus Q. So, vector P plus vector Q. So, ang P mo is ito. And then, ang Q is 4i minus 3j plus 2k. So, dito, in-apply lang natin yung property. Doing such, ang nakuha natin is 9i minus 2j minus k. So, mapapansin nyo, in between the component, laging plus yung operation. So, regardless of addition, subtraction, ipa-plus mo siya. So, like for this example, letter B, vector P minus Q. So, it is sabi ko, combine the similar components, pero the operation between the component is plus. So, doing such, ang nakuha nating sagot is I plus 4J minus 5K. Next is the magnitude of vector P for letter C. So, simply lang for getting the magnitude of any vector, ang gagawin mo lang is just to get the square root of the sum, or ganito lang, square mo yung bawat component, then kunin mo yung sum nun, saka mo kunin yung square root. And then, that would be the magnitude of P. So, pag ganito yung sign, hindi ibig sabihin niya na absolute value. If may nakita kayong P na may curl sa ilalim, ibig sabihin nun, ang hinahanap is the magnitude. So, again, ha, kunin mo lang yung square ng bawat component, i-add mo yon. Pagka-add, kunin mo yung square root. That is the magnitude. So, letter D. So, ito is, letter D is 2Q minus 10P. So, vector Q and vector P. So, pag scalar siya, you just have to distribute the scalar to the vector. So, dito, since 2Q, so, may value yung vector Q. So, distribute mo yung turon, which come up here. And then, for the 10P, ganun din. So, 10 times vector P. So, ito siya. Distribute mo rin yung scalar. Before mo perform yung operation, which is subtraction. Then again, 2Q minus 10P, so laging plus or addition yung pagkita ng component. Then perform mo yung operation, which is subtraction, dun sa same component. So pagka ganyan, dadalhin, let's say for the negative 3J, so kukunin natin yung ano, this is negative 6. So sa negative 6, sama mo yung sign dun before mo i-add ito. So dadalhin niya yung sign niya. So, meron tayong dalawang klaseng product. So, for the vector, it is the dot and cross product. So, dot cross product. So, ibig sabihin lang ng dot. Sa dot product, ito is a scalar. Whereas the cross product, that is a vector value. So, pag sinabing dot product, ibig sabihin na magiging sagot mo is just a whole number. Whereas pag cross product, meron ka mga components. So, for the dot product, ang gagawin mo lang is simply multiply the respective components, then kunin mo yung sum nun. So, ang example natin dito is vector A is equal to 2i plus 3j minus k, and then vector B is i plus 2j plus k. So, kunin daw yung dot product, A dot B. So, kunin mo lang yung similar component. So, the i component is 1 and 2, diba? 2 and 1, tapos 3 and 2. Then, negative 1 and 1. So, minultiply natin yung bawat component and then i-add mo. So, the dot product is equal to 7. Pag sinabi namang cross product, so, i-align natin yung i tsaka, or i-align natin yung components. Kukunin mo yung i, j, and k components. So, ganito ang gagawin mo. And then, kunin mo yung mga coefficients for that. So, 2, 3, and negative 1. So, 2, 3, negative 1. And then, 1, 2, and 1. So, 1, 2, and 1. Then, kunin mo yung determinant. So, ang ginamit ko rito is Cramer's rule. So, 3 by 3. So, nire-write ko yung first two columns. Tapos, kinuha ko yung determinant. And then, ganun pa rin siya. So, alam nyo na yung pagkuha ng determinant, perform yung operation, yun ang maging cross product. And then, the cross product is 5i minus 3j plus k. So, for the theta, so yung mga formula naman na yan is available na dun sa in-upload kong PDF about vector calculus na ano pa yun, na third year, di ba? No. Na-delay siya dahil nga nakat yung semester. So, for the theta, yung sabihin niyan is the angle between the vector, and then the formula for that is simply madi-derive from the dot product. So, A dot B is equal sa magnitude of A, so nakalimutan ko yung magnitude dito, yung sign ng vector, and then the magnitude of B. So, magnitude of A and B times cosine theta. So, theta is the angle between the two vectors. So, kunin mo muna yung, sinahanap ang theta, kunin mo muna yung magnitude ng both vector, pagkakuha mo ng magnitude, apply mo na yung formula. So for the theta, you just have to have the arc cosine of the dot product divided by the product of the magnitude. So doing such, nakuha nating angle is 40.20 degrees. So usually degrees naman yan pag angle. Next topic is vector differential calculus. So for the vector differential calculus, you just simply follow the basic differentiation na nagkaroon lang ng component. So for example, if vector A is equal to 3u square I minus 2uj plus 5k, so find out the first derivative of vector A with respect to u and then the second derivative of A with respect to u. So doing such, so gawin mo lang dyan parang ano is the I or the u rather, yun yung magiging independent variable mo. So getting the first derivative is simply 6ui minus 2j. So ito is constant na, so derivative of constant is 0. So kunin natin yung second derivative. Second derivative ang maiiwan na lang is 6, 6i. Kasi ito constant na siya, wala na siya with respect to u. So simpleng-simple lang, diba? So another example for vector differential calculus is just this. The position of a moving particle at time t is given by x is equal to 40 plus 3, y is equal to t square plus 3t, and then z is equal to t cube plus 5t square. So obtain the velocity and acceleration of the particle, and then letter b, the magnitude of acceleration and velocity. So magnitude of acceleration, then magnitude of velocity. So, for physics, the concept with regards to calculus is that the first derivative of the vector, or rather, the position vector, kunin mo yung derivative ng position, you will have the velocity. And then, differentiating it again, you will have the acceleration. So, kung i-reverse mo yung process, the first integral of acceleration is velocity. And then, the second integral of acceleration is position. So, with respect to time. Lahat ng sinabi ko, with respect to time. So, for letter A, so, ito na yung given na vector, no? So, hanapin daw yung velocity or acceleration of the particle. So, kailangan mong i-define yung position vector. And position vector is simply xi plus yi plus zk. So, ito siya. That is the position vector. And then, may value yung individual components based sa given. Substitute mo lang siya doon. So, for the velocity, so following the position vector, so substitute mo yung mga given na x, y, and z, and then kunin mo yung first derivative with respect to time. So, ito yung naging sagot. So, r prime is equal to 4i plus 2t plus 3j plus quantity 3t square plus 10k. So, this is the velocity. So, kunin mo yung second derivative dito with respect to time, that is the acceleration. So, acceleration is simply, so ito is 0 na, ang naiwan dito with respect to time is 2 na lang. So, 2j, and then this would be 6t plus 10, which is this. So, ito na yung acceleration vector natin. Next is the magnitude. Sabi, hinahanap is magnitude and acceleration velocity, magnitude of acceleration and velocity at t is equal to 1. So, ganun lang. Kunin mo yung, since nakuha muna yung respective vectors for the acceleration and velocity, substitute mo lang yung value which is t is equal to 1 dun sa equation. So, for the magnitude of velocity, substitute mo yung 1 sa t. Then, kunin mo yung bawat component, square mo yon, and then yun na. Kunin mo square root, yun na yung magiging magnitude. So, for the magnitude of velocity at t is equal to 1. So, substituting 1 to the equation. So, ito wala namang substitute dyan. Pero may 4. So, ang nakuha is 4 and then 5 and then 13. So, kunin mo yung square ng bawat component. Add mo. And then, kunin mo yung square root. That is the magnitude of velocity at t is equal to 1. So, the answer is square root of 210. Same as with acceleration. So, mas maigli acceleration. Substitute mo yung t rito, which is 1. So, makukuha mong component 0 for I, 2 for J, and then 16 for K, which is so 0 square plus 2 square plus 16 square is equal to 260. Kunin mo square root nun, yun yung magnitude ng acceleration at T is equal to 1. So, next example is the partial derivatives of vectors. So, ganun lang naman yan. Kung saang with respect to, doon mo lang i-differentiate. So, that is simple enough to be discussed. So, ito nagkataon lang ng second derivative of f with respect sa partial ng u and then partial of b is equal to the second derivative of f with respect to partial of b and then partial of u. Kasi pag nag-evaluate tayo ng mga higher order derivatives, ang treatment natin sa ilalim is from the left to right. So, una mo siyang differentiate with respect to u, then with respect to v. So, it happened lang na equal siya. Pero not all the time na equal yan. Next is vector integral calculus. So, for the vector integral calculus, ganun lang din. Simply, the concept is about integral. Yun nga lang, vector yung ni-integrate mo. So, for example, is if vector f is equal to 3t squared plus 4t, quantity I plus quantity 2j minus 5j plus quantity 4t cube k. So, calculate the integral of f dt from 1 to 3. So, kung f dt, ito na yung f mo, di ba? So, integrate mo to with respect to t. So, magkakaiwalay pa rin yung per component. So, substituting the values, then, ito yung boundaries niya from 1 to 3. So, again, integrate mo siya rather with respect to t. So, the answer is 42i minus 2j plus 80k. So, yun lang naman for the vector calculus. Vector integral calculus. The next topic would be the del operator. So, meron tayong tatlong del operator, the gradient, the curl, and divergence. So, first we will discuss the gradient, which is del phi. Ito siya, del and then the phi. So, for the gradient, sabi dyan, example, if phi is equal to x square y z cube plus xy square times z cube, determine the gradient at point 1, 3, 2. So, ano bang gagawin natin for the gradient? So, for the gradient, ang gagawin lang is usually ano? The process is simply kunin mo lang yung ano? Kunin mo lang yung partial derivatives with respect to x, y, and z, and then substitute the given point. So, dito, the given point is 1, 3, 2. So, again, ang sabi is solve for the partial derivative of the function with respect to x, y, z. So, kunin mo, so since this is phi, kunin mo yung partial with respect to x, y, and z. Pag nakuha mo na siya, yun na yung magiging, ito na yung magiging x component, the y component, and then the z component. So, pag nakuha mo na yung partial derivative, substitute mo na yung point. Ang given point is 1, 3, 2. Substituting that, dito, so, mamaintain yung I, J, and K na component. And then, yun na. Pag substitute mo, the gradient would be 84I plus 32J plus 72K. So, simple lang. No? Kunin mo yung partial derivative with respect sa lahat ng components, X, Y, and Z. And then, pag samasamahin mo yon, maintaining the component na I, J, and K, and then substitute the given points, if any. If walang given na point, let's say walang given na 1, 3, 2, yun yung magiging final answer mo. Yung nakuha mong partial derivatives. So, next topic is the directional derivative. So, before tayo mag-proceed sa curl and divergence, doon muna tayo sa directional derivative. For the directional derivative, so sabi dyan, directional derivative of phi in the direction of vector A is equal to, so the derivative of phi with respect to x is equal to the vector A times the gradient phi, where vector A is equal to dr over the magnitude of dr. So steps in solving, first is to solve the gradient, then solve for the A, which is dr divided by the magnitude of r, or dr rather. Then perform the dot product, kasi nga, di ba, this is dot product. So, perform the dot product between a and then the gradient. So, doing such, yun na daw yung directional derivative, which is derivative of phi with respect to x. So, ito yung directional derivative. Derivative nga, kaya may d. So, example, so, if phi is x square z plus 2xy square plus yz square at point 1 to negative 1, and then the given vector A is 2i plus 3j minus 4k. So, again, Remembering the process in solving gradient is kunin mo yung individual derivative with respect to x, y, and z component. And then, pag nakuha mo yun, pag sama-samahin mo, this is the I component, this is the j component, and then this is the z component, which is this. Then, substitute mo yung given points. So, may given points ka na 1, 2, negative 1, and then, substituting that to the equation, yun na yung gradient mo. So, the gradient at 1, 2, negative 1 is 6i plus 9j minus 3k. So, may given ka na vector A. Kunin mo lang daw yung dot product nitong vector A tsaka nito. Diba? Pero, before pala, ang A mo is, nakalimutan ko. Ang A mo is equal to derivative of R or dr over the magnitude. So, given naman yung vector. So, ito siya. So, ito na yung dr mo, bale. So, for the dr, that is the behavior of this, the vector, the given vector field, which is 2i plus 3j minus 4k, divided by the magnitude. So, ito siya. So, ito yung magiging A mo. So, wala ka na pala i-compute. Kasi yung dr mo is usually, ito na. I-divide mo lang siya ng magnitude niya. Yun ang magiging A. So, solving for the A, which is this. So, perform mo na yung dot product. So, pag sinabing dot product, kukonday mo lang yung similar components and then i-add mo. So, convey mo yung A or multiply mo yung X component, which is 6, tapos 2 times 2 over square root of 39, tapos yung 9 times 3 square root of 29, which is this, and then negative 3 times negative 4 square root of 29. So, ito na magiging directional derivative. So, this is the dot product. Next is the unit normal vector. For the unit normal vector, so, ang gagawin mo lang, ang formula dyan is, pag pinapasa natin unit normal, that is the perpendicular line with respect to sa tangent. So, ang formula is simply the gradient over the magnitude of the gradient. Sabi dyan, calculate the unit normal vector at 1, negative 1, 1 for 2yz plus xa plus xy is equal to 0. So, madali lang, kunin mo yung gradient. Pag nakuha mo yung gradient, which is this, ang gradient is 2i plus j minus a plus k. So, kunin mo yung magnitude nito. So, the magnitude is square root of 6. So, divide mo siya doon. So, ito siya. Ito lang. Per component ka pa. Para ka lang kumuha ng slope. Diba? Next is the divergence of the vector. So, this is the second del operator. So, ang symbol niya is dot product. This is the easiest among the three kasi dot product siya. So, alam mo na yung process ng dot product. Diba? So, dito, ang magiging process lang in solving the divergence is to ano? In solving the divergence of a vector, solve the partial derivatives. And then, substitute the given points if any. So, kunin mo yung partial derivative lang nung with respect dun sa component. So, ito, kunin mo yung partial niya with respect sa x. Kunin mo yung partial nito with respect sa y and then partial with respect to z. Kaya naging siyang ganito. Diba? So, yun na. Pag nakuha mo yun, pag nakuha mo yung partial derivative, substitute mo na yung given points, which is 1, 2, 3. And since that is that product, ang sagot mo dapat is walang component. So, the divergence is equal to 13. For the curl of a vector, so, ito yung pinakamabusisi sa tatlo since this is cross product. So, ganun pa rin naman yung step. So, may given ka na vector. So, ang gagawin mo is just to perform the cross product doon sa loob ng vector. Pero, before mo makuha yon is to get the since cross product yan, kukunin mo yung derivative. Diba? Derivative ng vector. So, ang una mong gagawin dyan, ito is the format for the given vector. So, ijk yung first row. The second row is partial with respect to partial of x, then partial with respect to partial of y, and then partial with respect to partial of z. And then, kunin mo yung component, individual component, yung x, y, and z component. So, lagay mo rito. And then, perform a 3, get the determinant of that matrix. So, if 3 by 3, so using Cramer's rule, copy mo yung first two columns, which is this. then perform mo na yung pagkuha ng determinant. Pag nakuha mo na yung determinant, which is this, substitute mo na yung given points. So, the final answer is 2i plus 8j minus 106k. So, yun lang naman yung curl of a vector. So, next topic is the scalar field integral. So, for the scalar field integral or the v-integral, the first step is solve for v. Then, solve for r and dr. And then, if not given, solve for the boundaries from the given point. So, mamaya makikita nyo kung paano mag-solve ng boundaries. But that is simply substitute the given points or kung may na-dinify na doon na boundary. And then, integrate VDR. So, yung sabihin nito, line integral na to eh. So, integrate the line integral of VDR. Pero ang tawag dito is scalar field or V-integral. So, first, so example, so if V is equal to XY square Z and a curve C is given by X is equal to 3U, Y is equal to 2U square, Z is equal to U cube, find the scalar field integral, VDR, along C from 0, 0 to 3, 2, 1. So this is the second point, this is the first point. So solution is solve for V. So V, given siya, di ba? So gagawin mo dyan, substitute mo yung mga given na value for each component. So doing such, ito na siya. So naging siya 3U times 2U square raised to square, tas U cube. So ang naging V is 12 times U raised to 8. So yun yung first step. So ang second step is solve for R and DR. So ang R is simply the ano, parang position vector. So 3UI plus 2U square J plus U cube K. And then kunin mo yung derivative mo with respect sa U, yun yung DR. So nakuha mo na yung R and DR. Ang next naman is to get the or to solve the boundaries. So paano mo susolve yung boundaries? So una, di ba may dalawa kang given na points. Point A is 0, 0, 0 and then B is 3, 2, 1. So ang gagawin mo lang is ganito. Since may equation ka na for the X, Y and Z, so substitute mo dun yung points. So, di ba, x is equal to 3u, y is equal to 2u square, z cube is equal to u cube. So, substitute mo yung mga given points dun. So, dito, unanimously, ang u is equal to 0. So, usually, uniform yan all throughout. So, ito yung magiging first boundary. Since uniformly equal siya sa 0, this is u, ha? This is u, not y. So, U is equal to 0, lahat, unanimously. So, the first point is 0. Then, second point is 3, 2, 1. So, substitute mo rin yung 3, 2, 1. So, this is X, Y, and Z doon sa given. Then, unanimously, ang U mo is equal to 1 also. So, given to U, so, ibig sabihin, ito yung magiging interval mo for your integral. So, ang boundary mo is from 0 to 1. Kaya ito is naging from 0 to 1. Tapos, V dot DR. Diba? Ang V mo is 12U8. And then, multiply mo sa DR, which is the derivative ng R. So, ito siya. And then, perform mo the operation, then integrate mo with respect sa U. So, doing that, ang nakuwang VDR is 4i plus 24 over 5j plus 36 over 11k. So, if medyo nalilito ka sa process, so sundan mo lang itong given procedures and then you independently solve hanggang sa ma-familiarize sa process. Pero ito lang naman yung 4 procedures to be done. So, last topic would be the vector field or the F-integral. So, for the vector field or F-integral, so let A be the vector field. So, may given yung vector field mo and then dr is equal to dxi plus dyj plus dzk. So, ang procedure is solve for f. Then, solve for r dr. Solve for the boundaries if not given. Then, integrate f dot dr naman siya. So, for the vector field or f integral, so sabi dyan, calculate the line integral of f dot dr from 0, 0, 0 to 4 to 1. Along the curve x is equal to 4t, y is equal to 2t squared, z is equal to t cube. If the vector f is given na x squared yi plus xzj minus 2yzk. So, solving for f, So yung f mo, di ba, given ito. And then may value yung bawat x, y, and z, which is this. So substitute mo lang siya. So makuha mo yung f. So yun na yung solving for f. So ang f mo is 32t raised to 4i plus 4t raised to 4j minus 4t raised to 5k. Then solving for r, so for the r, so parang position vector lang. Alalahanin nyo, pag r, ang format niya is parang position vector. And then substitute mo yung given points from the given. Given na nga from the given. So substitute the given points or given values. And then get the derivative with respect to t. So ito siya. So ito na yung magiging dr with respect to t. And then kailangan munang i-solve yung boundary. So yun pa rin, same process with the scalar field integral. So equate mo lang siya since 0-0 na siya. So equate mo. So unanimously t is equal to 0 the first point, and then substitute mo naman yung 4-2-1. So ito siya, di ba? Ito yung magiging, di ba, x, y, and z. Tapos ito x, y, and z. So ang x mo is 4 is equal to 4t, 2 is equal to 2t square, and 1 is equal to t cube. So unanimous t is equal to 1. So ang value is from value ng t is from 0 to 1. So yun ang magiging boundary. So perform mo na. So, di ba, this is f.dr. So, once you get the f and then the dr, perform mo lang yung cross product, yung dot product rather. And then, performing the dot product. So, pag sinabing dot product, pagsasamahin mo lang yung mga same components, which is the x, y, and z component lang. Kaya 32 times 4 is 128. 4 times 4 is 16. And then, 4 na negative times 3 is negative 12. So, doing such, integrate mo with respect to t or dt. Then, the boundary is 0 to 1. And then, yun na, integrate mo. So, since that is dot product, gagawin mo is, walang component yung final answer. Kocombine mo yung x, add mo yung x, y, and z component. Which is 803 over 30. So, yun lang naman siya. So, ang pinagkaiba dito is dito integrate ka VDR. So that is a scalar field integral. Pagdating mo sa vector field integral, ang sagot mo is parang scalar. So baliktad siya. Okay, malilito doon. Again, vector field F integral, ang sagot dyan is scalar form. Sa scalar naman, naka-component siya. So yun lang naman yung conclusion ng topics natin for vector calculus. So please use the PowerPoint as a reference for the formula. And then, ito yung mga problem. I encourage you to rewrite the problem and then solve it. Tapos, tignan mo kung magkakapares kayo ng sagot dito sa uploaded video.